Welcome back to our investigation. What is happening in McKenna's body that's making her feel sick? We've narrowed it down to two diseases, celiac disease and Crohn's disease. Today we'll look more at the symptom of weight loss. Last lesson, we started to think about what the purpose of food is. Our bodies break down large food molecules into small food molecules so our cells can use them. Every cell in our body has an organelle called the mitochondria, which is responsible for making energy for the cell. Small food molecules are used as the fuel in the mitochondria. Just like your car uses gas as fuel to make energy, mitochondria use glucose molecules, amino acid molecules, and fatty acid molecules as fuel to make energy. Humans also need to take in other materials in their bodies in order to survive. For instance, we have to breathe in oxygen. In addition to poop and pee, humans also get rid of other materials from their bodies. One example of this is when we exhale or breathe out. Today we will investigate what is causing McKenna to experience weight loss. One thing you'll look at today is a chart that shows McKenna's height and weight from when she was 8 years old to when she was 14 years old. Notice that height is measured in centimeters and it's marked in orange, and weight is measured in kilograms and it's marked in blue. You'll notice these lines, 25th percentile, 50th percentile, and 75th percentile. 50th percentile means that you're average, you're right in the middle. If you're in the 25th percentile for height, it means that 24% of students your age are shorter than you, and 75% are taller. You can see McKenna's height over time and McKenna's weight over time, and you can compare it to the average for kids in her